Hello, this is Nick, aka Artifacts, and in this tutorial I'm going to demonstrate how you can transform your Microsoft Windows desktop environment, which is what you're looking at right now, to a Mac-like desktop environment. The first step in making your PC Mac-like is changing your wallpaper with an Apple-like background. This is a fairly simple thing to do. Use Google Images to find a wallpaper that you like. Use a keyword like Mac wallpaper to define your search. Once you have found a wallpaper you like, open its full-size image, right-click, and save the image to your computer. Now that you have your desired wallpaper saved, go to where you saved your picture, right-click it, and select Set as Desktop Background. Your wallpaper should then change. The next step is getting a Mac-like dock for your desktop. For this tutorial, I'll be using the Nexus from WinStep. This program hasn't gotten as much attention as products like the Object Dock or the Rocket Dock, but I have found that this program offers many features for free that other products require you to pay for. So go to their website as seen below at www.winstep.net/nexus.asp. And once you're there, download and install the free version of their software by clicking the Download from CNET button. Now go to your desktop and right-click on your taskbar. Select Properties from the menu and change the taskbar location from the bottom of the screen, or wherever you have it, to the top. Also check the auto hide option in the window. Then press OK. This may seem odd, but I assure you that it will make sense later on in this video. If you have installed the Nexus, run it. Then right click on the corner of the dock and select Preferences. Go to the Themes tab and choose Leopard from the list. Next, go to the Tasks tab and check the option to show currently running apps in the dock. Finally, press OK. You should now have a Mac-like dock. The next step is getting a Mac-like menu bar for the top of your desktop. The program I'm going to be using is called the iBar. This program was created by me, as there was no freeware program of similarity that I could find, or at least a free similar program that I liked. Open up your web browser once again and navigate to the following address as seen on your screen, www.ibar.weebly.com. Now go to the Download tab and click Download to download and install the program. Now go back to your web browser and search Google Images, or whatever search engine you prefer, using keywords such as Apple logo. Once you have found a good-looking Apple logo to use, save it to your computer. Open the image with your favorite image editor and scale the image down to a size of 22 pixels by 22 pixels. Then save the image. Now run the iBar and go to Preferences in the menu bar. In the Preference window, change the Start button logo from the default in the drop-down menu list to a custom image. Press the Set Custom button. A window should come up allowing you to set a custom image. Choose the Apple logo that you saved, and then press OK. Then press OK once more. You should now have a Mac-like menu bar and dock, along with a Mac-like desktop wallpaper. For more information about this video, visit my website at http://artifactsproductions.blogspot.com.
Artifacts tutorial on auto-tuning.
Here's what you're going to need to get started. You're going to need Audacity 1.3 beta or higher, a microphone, GSnap, which is a plugin, by the way, and possibly a VST bridge plugin. So here it goes, and I'm going to play it back so you can hear what it sounds like. And this is what it sounds like.
But I'm going to start by doing something very simple. I'm going to take my voice, and I'm going to put it into the program. If I can do it right now, you can see it. You can see the bar going across the screen as I talk. You want to make sure, though, that when you're talking...
Windows has encountered an error. Can't do that. Can't do that.